Do you know when, like, you start killing an ant and, like, it loses a leg or something, and then it starts spinning around, like, trying to find its footing without a leg, and it's trying to survive, and it's kind of, like, weird? That's how I was. That was me. I was, like, in circles, freaking the fuck out, in survival mode, but also, like, literally hyperventilating. Really good music, like, it's undeniable. It's just really good. The one time she was on radio and she was like, oh, who's still around? And so I tweeted at her and she was like live on radio fucking bawling laughing, going, ha ha, Nicole, you're the GIF queen. And so we started a friendship, a virtual friendship, and I'm seeing her perform tonight and I'm so excited. I'm also shooting the show. When I'm alone, it's automatic. I dig the life. So we got in the Uber and we got there, and lo and fucking behold, we get to the venue and this girl is on stage, like, checking the sounds of her guitar. That's where I paralyzed. Chaos. Just absolute chaos descended upon me. I was sweating a lot. I felt like I was gonna burst at any given moment. I mean, this is gonna sound so weird. I promise I'm professional. I promise. This is not what happens with every single person that I photograph. It's just, she gets me on another plane. When you listen to something like that, coming from another woman, it just makes you feel as empowered and confident and bold and, like, ready to take on the world and take down the patriarchy if need be, and, like, stuff like that. And her music really makes me feel like I can do anything. I think it's, like, identity wise we match a lot, because we don't like conforming, we don't give a fuck about what people think about us, and it's just, this is who I am. And I feel like every single record that goes by, she's less filtered. And I love that, because I feel that in my life, every year that goes by, my already very small filter just keeps decreasing. And I keep getting more confident, hopefully, and more sure of myself. And I feel like I see that progression in with her music as well. And just having that to soundtrack my, maybe, like, the most crucial years of my life, because I found her when I was 19 and now I'm 22, so, like, the last 3 years have been really formative with my expectations of what, like, what a young woman can be and what she can do, and which in her eyes and her world and in mine as well is anything that she fucking wants. And I think that's awesome. I love her for that. When I'm alone, so we went into the venue again and I started dancing, and then I saw her dancing. Then I was like, okay, yeah, maybe this is a crush. Like, okay, cool. I have to figure out my sexuality in the middle of all this. I have to, like, figure out what I'm feeling, because it was too much for me to handle. But are you fucking kidding me right now? Then I was freaking out and Luca was filming me freak out again, which is, like, if you're freaking out internally, or if you're freaking out with a friend, that's okay. If someone is filming you freak out, it just seems weird. And at a venue with, like, 30 people, they're gonna be like, who the fuck is this vlogger from YouTube with a cameraman behind her, laying her hands on the wall, looking like she's gonna give birth, but, like, having someone film the whole experience? Because it looked so staged, but it wasn't. It truly was not. By the moment she started playing, I kind of, like, stopped being nervous, because not only did I have a job to do, which was photograph her, but I could like just let myself be carried away by the moment. Like there was no anxiety, like I'd reached the thing that I was hoping for, which was seeing her play. So everything was gone by then. And then I spoke to her and I was like, hi. And she was like really shy, like, hi. And I said, I'm Nicole. And she's like, wait, like as in the GIF Queen. And I was like, yes, me. And so she gave me a huge hug, which was such a relief. And like, it was so sweet. I'm so sad that like it didn't last longer. Honestly, it's one of those things that like you never want it to end. I don't know, we started talking and she was like, you're a legend. I can't believe we're meeting. Every time that you're supposed to be somewhere that we're gonna meet, like you're never there. And she said that my gifts are the best and that they're always on point. And I thanked her a lot for the title. I had no confidence in my selection of gifts in life until she told me that the gifts that I selected were great and that I was GIF royalty. And I bought a CD because I wanted her to sign it for me because I wanted a souvenir. So I have a prop. See, it says, she was like, can I write to my GIF queen? Note the possessive, my GIF queen, not only GIF queen, I'm her GIF queen, know what I mean? So yeah, she wrote to my GIF queen and I will treasure this forever. Oh, we took a selfie. We're so cute. I've been staring at that photo for a really long time. This is our 1 week anniversary of us meeting. And so I edited the photos, I posted them to Twitter, and then I posted a GIF. And that was like actual footage of the two of us meeting, and it's this one really tall guy, like just standing there, and this like really tiny guy runs up to him and like jumps on him and hugs him. And then she replied on the next morning like, ha ha ha, yes. So that's it. That's what I did. And then I went to bed with a smile on my face like a stupid person.